Hello friends, let us see a problem on frequency response. So the problem says, find the frequency response of a second order system. It is written as of a second order system whose difference equation is given as y of n minus 1 plus 3 by 16 y of n minus 2 equals to x of n minus 1 by 2 x of n minus 1. So I have this difference equation given to me, in which the output now depends on input, past outputs also. So we have two past outputs, one is delayed by 1 and second is delayed twice, and we have two inputs, one is the present input and one is the past input. So the current output y of n depends on inputs as well as outputs. Now let us solve this solution. Step 1 will be applying Z transform. When I apply Z transform, replaces y of n to y of z, x of n to x of z, and wherever there is delay, multiplied by z raised to negative powers. So we have y of z minus, here we have a delay of 1, so I have to multiply it by a negative power of z, y of z, plus 3 by 16, which is constant. Here there is a delay of 2, so I have to multiply it by z raised to minus 2, 2 y of z equals to x of z minus 1 by 2 z inverse x of z. Now pulling out y of z common, x of z common, and getting the h of z. So we get y of z as 1 minus z inverse plus 3 by 16 z raised to minus 2 equals to x of z into 1 minus 1 by 2 z inverse. Therefore, I can write y of z by x of z as, which is equal to h of z as, 1 minus 1 by 2 z inverse divided by 1 minus z inverse plus 3 by 16 z raised to minus 2. So this is my transfer function. Now to go ahead, I have to find the roots of this equation. Or you can solve directly also, but root of the equation will be better. Now what we'll do is, before going to finding the root of the equation, let us replace all negative powers of z to positive powers of z. That we can do by multiplying z square in the numerator and the z square in the denominator. My h of z will look like, h of z will be z square minus 1 by 2 z divided by z square minus z plus 3 by 16. Now I will pull z common out. I'll get z into z minus 1 by 2 divided by, here we can see this is a polynomial with a degree 2. So we will have two roots, and two roots comes as z minus 1 by 4 and z minus 3 by 4. So the equation of this can be written as z minus 1 by 4 and z minus 3 by 4. So now my h of z is equal to z into z minus 1 by 2 divided by z minus 1 by 4 into z minus 3 by 4. Just a recall statement. Here the 0 is at 0 and 1 by 2, and the pole is at 1 by 4 and 3 by 4. This is not a part of the problem, but just to recall, this is the zeros and the poles of the system. Now let us go ahead and solve the magnitude and the phase response. Step 2, replace z by e raised to j omega with 1 as the radius. So my h of e raised to j omega will be equal to e raised to j omega into e raised to j omega minus 1 by 2 divided by e raised to j omega minus 1 by 4 into e raised to j omega minus 3 by 4. Now, I will write using Euler's identity, we can write e raised to j omega as cos omega plus j sine omega. This is a Euler's identity. So we write cos omega. So we replace all e's with respect to this identity plus j sine omega into cos omega plus j sine omega minus 1 by 2 divided by e raised to cos omega plus j sine omega minus 1 by 4 into cos omega plus j sine omega minus 3 by 4. Now the numerator part becomes complicated if I open up like this. So let us rework a little. With the rework, what I do is with e raised to j omega itself, when I write it e raised to j omega into e raised to j omega minus 1 by 2 divided by, let us keep the denominator as it is. I am not changing the denominator. I am just reworking with the numerator to simplify the equation. So here what we do is I multiply this e raised to j omega inside. So I can get e raised to 2 j omega minus 1 by 2 e raised to j omega. Okay, what this will do is divided by the complete denominator cos of omega plus j sine omega minus 1 by 4 into cos of omega plus j sine omega minus 3 by 4. What this will do is this will simplify your further calculations. When you write e raised to 2 j omega, now that becomes cos 2 omega plus j sine 2 omega minus 1 by 2 cos omega. This minus brings inside 1 by 2 also and a j with sine omega divided by cos omega plus j sine omega minus 1 by 4 into cos omega plus j sine omega minus 3 by 4. Now, let us take the magnitude response of this equation. So, before going to magnitude response, let us rearrange first to make it thoda look better. E raised to j omega will be equal to, pulling out all real parts together, I get cos 2 omega and minus 1 by 2 cos omega. This will go together. And then I put plus over here, j. And then we have sine 2 omega minus 1 by 2 sine omega divided by cos omega minus 1 by 4 plus j sine omega, I'll put a brace bracket over here, into cos omega minus 3 by 4 plus j sine omega. So let us solve the numerator part and the denominator part equally. So now here we can see that there is a real part and an imaginary part, a real part and an imaginary part, but the denominator have a multiplication sign into it. So first need to solve this. So we take only the denominator part and not the numerator alone. So I take only denominator and solve first. So I get cos omega minus 1 by 4 plus, this is one term, plus j sine omega. This whole term is multiplied by cos omega minus 3 by 4 plus j sine of omega. So let us multiply. We have 4 terms in all because 2 terms multiplied by 2 terms. I'll get this multiplied by this gives me cos omega minus 1 by 4 into cos omega minus 3 by 4. Then we multiply this with this, it gives them plus j sine omega into cos omega minus 1 by 4. Then we multiply this with this, it becomes plus j sine omega cos omega minus 3 by 4. And this with this will give me minus, because j into j gives me j square. And to recall, j square is equal to minus 1. So we have j into j, j square, which will give minus 1, and sine will give me minus sine square omega. Okay. Now I will again rearrange that equations, and we get all real terms we will combine together. I get cos omega minus 1 by 4 into cos omega minus 3 by 4. Then we have a term minus sine square omega, and rest are the imaginary terms which I write as plus, because both goes with a similar sign. Plus j I pull out common, and then I write like this: cos omega minus 1 by 4 and plus cos omega minus 3 by 4, and then the whole multiplied by sine of omega. So this is my real term and this is my imaginary term. So I highlight the terms. This term is the real part. It does not have any j term associated with it. And this one is the imaginary part, because it is coming with along with j. Now, this was only denominator part, there is numerator also. So the magnitude of h of e raised to j omega says under root of real part square plus the imaginary part square. So I have to square the real part and the imaginary part individually and take its under root. So that is a magnitude. So when I take magnitude of h of e raised to j omega, I have a numerator part and I have a denominator part. So numerator magnitude will be calculated separately and denominator will be calculated separately, and they will be divided as normal. So I represent the numerator part. The numerator part under root will be, the real part in the numerator is cos 2 omega minus 1 by 2 cos omega the whole square, and the denominator part is plus sine 2 omega minus 1 by 2 sine omega the whole square. So for the numerator, I have this as my real part and this as my imaginary part and its square and its root, divided by, now for the denominator, it's a huge term. So this part square plus this part square, let us call this as A and let us call this as B. So I have A square plus B square, where A square is cos omega minus 1 by 4, cos omega minus 3 by 4 minus sine square, and B term is cos omega minus 1 by 4 plus cos omega minus 3 by 4 into sine omega. So this is the required transfer function, sorry, magnitude response of a given system. Now let us concentrate on the angle of this system. Now the angle of h of e raised to j omega is given as tan inverse of imaginary part upon the real part. So I have to take the imaginary part and divide it by real part and it take its tan inverse, that will give me the required function, which we called as the phase function or the angle function. Now here for the numerator part, I will take this function, but there is no division in angles. There is no division in angles. So how to go about? So if we have a A function and a B function, this is just a recall part. So if I have a complex number which is A by B, where A is given as A plus IB and B is given as X plus IY, and if I wanted to find, let us say this is my function phi, then if I wanted to find the angle phi, then I will find tan inverse of the imaginary part, which is B, upon the real part A, And for the denominator part, I will subtract, that is tan inverse of y by x. So whenever I have a denominator complex number, the angle, when I calculate the angle of the function, I have to subtract. Okay, so I will be subtracting. Now using the same concept, if I apply this concept onto the given problem, then my real part and the imaginary part will be for angle h of e raised to j omega, okay, I will have the numerator tan inverse, which is nothing but sine squared omega minus 1 by 2 sine omega divided by cos 2 omega minus 1 by 2 cos omega. Okay, this is a numerator part, and for denominator I will have minus tan inverse of, now the real part over here, the imaginary part over here is sine omega. Okay, we have the denominator part as sine omega into cos omega minus 1 by 4 plus cos omega, this is whole multiplied by cos omega minus 3 by 4 divided by, the real part is cos omega minus 1 by 4 into cos omega minus 3 by 4 minus sine square omega. So that is my phase response, and this is my magnitude response. So for the magnitude response, I have under root of real part square plus imaginary part square for numerator and for the denominator separately. Whereas for the phase response, we have to take tan inverse of imaginary part upon real part and subtract for the denominator part. There is no division or multiplication in angles. So this is the required phase and magnitude response of a system. Thank you.